Our organization provides marketing services broadly, ranging from digital media investment, linear media investment, to creative and content services. And from that standpoint, we're really well positioned for the turbulent times because there's a lot of levers that we can pull in order to drive value. I will say the unique aspect of right now is the consultative, kind of the consultative role that our organization is playing. As you can imagine, Andy, and I'm sure you've seen and read and heard, there's a lot of businesses whose like core value proposition can't exist right now because of COVID. And so it becomes more of a dialogue around, well, how is it that we can realize, a communication strategy, a marketing strategy around a new business offering or pivot our business accordingly? And there's been a tremendous amount of, from an illustration standpoint, there's been a tremendous amount of news coverage related to the fast casual industry. And you see some of the, and again, just an example here, but you see some of these businesses, Burger Kings of the world, the McDonald's of the world, who are really leaned into their digital strategy in order to get their product out to the customers. So going away from kind of a retail type of a design from a business ops standpoint and really turning into a direct consumer delivery vehicle for food. And it's been not only thoughtful from a strategy standpoint, but also has delivered real meaningful business results. I think there was an article last week about McDonald's business being relatively flat as a result of some of their shifting. For us, it's there's countless brands who have been kind of sidelined because of this pandemic. And, instead of it being kind of a management of a portfolio of media investments, it becomes kind of a consultative approach to understanding the business viability and the opportunity to shift strategy from an operations standpoint. We have a bunch of these monster brands who look at sports, live sports and live events as a real mechanism to stay relevant and to convey, to convey value, right? And we've really had to reimagine how to position those brands to not only get in front of the right audience, but also to get in front of, the volume, the scale, to realize the opportunity that's required in order to continue to drive the success of these businesses. And there's a whole slew of them. We work with a bunch of financial service brands, Capital One and Geico. We're doing a bunch of work in the telco space with the Sprint folks. And I referenced Burger King already. These guys, Constellation Brands, these guys really, they really rely on the association with live sports in order to reinforce their value proposition. And so for us to kind of figure out and reimagine where their brands can exist has been an ongoing challenge. And I think we don't have the silver bullet right now, but it's been a lot of optimizing around consumer behavior, right? Leaning into digital channels. And then it's been a lot of pivoting around messaging so that there's more of so you have something more relevant and less potentially opportunistic to share out during this kind of like sensitive period of time. So I don't know if you watch American Idol, Andy, I sure do. But if you do at all, you'll notice like a lot of the auto advertising from last night, at least, and prior weeks as well, has really gone from kind of a hardcore promotional value proposition standpoint or viewpoint to know options, right? Customer and consumer options around payment flexibility, low contact vehicle maintenance. So there, it's more about kind of finding where you can you have like a relevant message to share and finding a vehicle to convey that now that we're down these really huge live events. But at least that's one example. All media is down from an investment standpoint, and again, there are brands, big brands, who typically spend money in advertising who are fully on the sideline today, and that's that presents a problem for our industry broadly. And that won't be rectified, frankly, until we have a better sense of when, you know, some return to normalcy will occur. That being said, for folks who are navigating marketing today during this period, you've seen what should not be surprising. You've seen folks gravitate toward more measurable and accountable channels. We've seen some drop off in traditional media. We've seen some recovery in these like low, what have historically been referred to as lower funnel marketing activity, including affiliate marketing and search marketing, and to a lesser extent, social marketing as well. And I think you're going to see folks gravitate toward those types of performance related channels because they're flexible and they're dynamic, both on the messaging side of things, but also on the media side of things. So your overall risk is relatively low, right? Because you can control how much you put out there, and you can control the message that you get out there, and you can get pretty finite in terms of the audience that you're reaching. Alongside all of that stuff, obviously measurement, data analytics, infrastructure is incredibly important. So, you need to not only know whether or not you're giving yourself an opportunity to get in front of the right audience, but you need to know whether or not that's driving business today, right? And so all of these kind of performance, data-led, analytics-led areas of our organization are humming right now because marketers want more insight than they ever had because there's less certainty than there has been in the past. I'm imagining there's going to be, it's like a lot of people out there are prognosticating. I feel like channels, including social, are going to recover really quickly as people get their marketing strategy organized for all of the reasons that I've shared. They're flexible, they're dynamic, and you can limit risk. And then I think from there, you're going to see people really lean into some of the behaviors that we're seeing, including, of course, connected and OTT inventory really, spiking. And you're going to figure out how your marketer is going to figure out how to use dynamic assets in those environments in kind of a scalable way. So that spend should pick up pretty quickly as well. But timing wise, I think we're talking Q3. And unfortunately, I don't think we're going to see much through June, which is a difficult place to be for organizations like ours. But we're hopeful for Q3. We'll see a real peak in investment, or start to see a return to normal investment levels across those channels.